We welcome you to the Dana Center on the campus of Bentley University in Waltham, Massachusetts for the semifinal round of the Division II Women's Basketball East Regionals. In our first semifinal matchup, we have the 6th seed Bears of NYIT taking on the number 2 seed AIC Yellow Jackets. AIC yesterday was a 15th win away from home as a Mason drive and bucket. Chance for NYIT to tie it up or take the lead. Vukasavlovich scores and one. At home, AIC within one with 34 seconds left. Allen for three, short. Julie Williams, the offensive rebound. Allen will take it again. That time it's good. Second three-pointer of the game today for Allen and her sixth of the regional thus far.
AIC a perfect 3-0 against ECC opposition.
Bishop, the step back three.
Only made four threes this season.
Three-pointer for Knowlton is good. Nothing but net for Audrey Knowlton. Drive, stop, and score.
And again, AIC attacking duo with two personals.
Big screen by Ragab. Three-pointer by Gorey rattles home. Casey Gorey has made six three-pointers now on the season in 14 attempts. And a big shot right before halftime. It cuts the deficit to one.
For whatever reason, AIC is just a step slow in the second half so far.
Into the basket, Vukasavlovich. She's the double figures now with 10. Made was to institute that into the women's game because pressure defense like that wasn't rewarded enough.
Couldn't agree more.
Offensive rebound again for Watts and another bucket. Back-to-back offensive rebound putbacks by Dana Watts, and AIC leads by four.
So steady, Kamika Mason.
Williams open for three. Got it. One-point game.
And finally, Williams gets on the board. You need a little better angle on that pass. It's more of a straight-line pass.
Allen, her second three-pointer of the early minutes of this fourth quarter, and her fourth of the game. AIC reassume the lead. Watts trying to do it. She does. 14 points now for Watts. AIC back in front by two.
This is the most effective offensive unit, and it has good length defensively.
Vukasavlovich will tie it back up. What an incredible game here at Bentley. 68-68 coming up on 2.5 to go.
AIC has feasted on second chance points, especially in the second half.
Watts stripped by Allen. Big steal by Shanice Allen. She'll take it herself. She's fouled and will head to the free throw line. Shanice Allen with the rip and run and will head to the charity stripe. That ties the game for the 14th time today. Into Bishop, double team to the corner. Stepney for the lead. And out of bounds, it's NYIT ball with 5.6 seconds left. I've seen crazy things happen in college basketball, especially recently, so I'm not going to call this one until now. NYIT is going on to the East Regional Championship game, knocking off AIC tonight, 73-69.
Okay, standing here with Dina Ragab of the NYIT Bears, and congratulations, Dina, terrific win. Just talk about the feelings now for getting to the regional title game.
It's been an amazing senior year. We believe that we can be special from the beginning. Our coach has been inspiring us like all season long. So coming this far is just a dream come true, and we keep pushing. We're not done yet. It's amazing.
Well, you had a game yesterday against Philadelphia that wasn't quite as close as this. AIC presented different challenges. How is this one different from yesterday?
It's a lot different. We played AIC last year, and we lost by 30 points, so coming back here was like a revenge. Like, we can beat them, we can do this. We played them before, we know they're different, they're bigger than us, they're taller, they're more athletic, but just play with heart, that's all that matters, honestly. We wanted it more. We played to the last second, and we pulled through, thank God.
Well, congratulations, Dana, and good luck on Monday. Okay, back on the baseline here with head coach Anthony Crescito. And coach, first of all, congratulations on a great win. What's the feeling right now?
I mean, I'm reduced to an emotion. I'm basically in tears with my wife, and I'll be in tears with my players, but we got to get ready for Monday.
Okay, you were here a couple of years ago as a sixth seed as well, took on a conference opponent in Dowling, and played a good game there, but you came up a little bit short. That experience, you had a number of the players on that team here
on this year's team, just a couple of them. What was the experience like a couple of years ago, and how did that help you coming into this tournament?
Well, that's part of it, but we started playing basketball October 31st in California, and we saw Winona State, Academy of Art. Those are two NCAA teams. So we started so early, and then we had to play Stony Brook, and then we played Pace Adelphi. So this has been a long, long grind, and I think we got our second wins at the right time.
Terrific game today against AIC, a tight one back and forth. From a coach's perspective, how do you attack a team like AIC with such great length, especially defensively?
We had to be disciplined, we had to spread the floor, and we wanted to attack the corner, believe it or not. And we went to the corner quite a bit, and down the stretch we got rebounds. You don't get rebounds, we lose the game. And I give credit to my kids off the bench. Kids off the bench have been invaluable, and my staff's been amazing.
Coach, congratulations, terrific job, and we'll see you on Monday night.
For Steve Zerdelegate, I'm Scott Sudikoff, signing off from the Data Center at Bentley. You're watching the 2016 Division II East Regionals.